Yes, I'm recording now.
Okay, now we are going to start with the stuff like the cell division, which is actually mitosis. Okay, mitosis. What do you know about mitosis?
Mitosis is made up of interphase and mitosis, or
yeah.
So it's made up of like interphase, prophase, metaphase, anaphase, and telophase.
Okay, you are going into description, yes?
Yeah, sure.
You're going into descriptions, isn't it?
Yeah.
So I'm just asking you, what is a mitotic division? What is mitosis? Mitosis is a type of asexual reproduction in which the original number of the parental number of chromosomes are retained, or the original genetic makeup of the parent is retained in the offspring.
Oh.
Or there is another term that we use, mitosis is a type of cell division in which the genetic makeup of an individual is conserved in its offsprings. Whatever, there are different kind of words, okay? So since we are recording it, so no need to just copy it down, because already the thing is, you know, this is one way of good thing, like the golden words are recorded. Yes, so you can repeat, and whatever you like of your choice, then you can select those definition, or you can select the definition from the textbook, correct?
Yes.
So mitosis is a type of cell division where the original genetic makeup of the parents are retained, are conserved in their offsprings. Okay, there is no change, no variation, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, now once, whenever we are talking about a cell division is further divided into, every cell division is divided into two components, two parts, okay? Any cell division is actually comprised, either it is mitosis or meiosis. So first type of cell division, that is known as nuclear division, and the second part is what? Cytokinesis. So first the nucleus has to divide, correct?
Yeah.
And what is cytokinesis? A process in which the cytoplasm is divided into two, or into daughter cells, whether they are two or whether they are four. So first the nucleus divides, and second the cytoplasm divide, correct?
Yeah.
So in nuclear division, as you mentioned very correctly, there are two steps. One is the inactive stages, and one are the active stages. Active stages, or here we can say the main stages, okay? Inactive stages, we call it, I'm using this word, okay? It is not there in the book. Interphase, like you said, interphase.
Yeah.
Okay? And the active phase is, there you'll be writing interphase, okay? Active phase, inactive phases, okay? Just 1 minute. Here I have to write with the new thing, like it will be active phase, okay? This is active phase, inactive. And there is more, here you'll be writing, this is active phase, okay? So I've noticed one thing, Tia. You know the most difficult stuff, and once it comes to the easiest stuff, so you actually struggle.
Yeah.
Like most of the kids, you know?
Yeah, the basics are forgotten from ninth, like old grades.
That is what I mean. Seriously, I was just, you gave me a shocker actually. Okay, so nuclear division is divided into inactive phases and active phase, okay?
Yeah.
Or proper phase or improper phase, okay? So once we are talking about this thing, so here interphase, so inactive phase is interphase, correct? So interphase is further divided into what, if you can recall?
G1, S, G2.
Very nice, yes. G1, S, and
G2.
G1, then there is S phase, yes, S phase. And then there is a G2 phase, correct?
Yeah.
G2 phase, yes. And similarly, active stages of mitosis, obviously there are four stages: pro, meta, ana, telo. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Pro, meta, ana, and telo. I always call like this, so I think you can recall it. Pro, metaphase,
PBAT,
and ana and telo. Okay. Anaphase and telophase. Okay. Now, if we are going for the G1 phase, now this is the time for you to write, okay?
Okay.
Now, once we are talking about the... So, first of all, the nuclear division is first divided into two parts, interphase, which is actually inactive phase, okay? And other phases, which are pro, meta, ana, and telophase, they are the active phases, where the cell actually goes into cell division. So interphase is also one of the preparatory phase. Sometimes inactive means preparatory phase. The term inactive means preparatory phase. Interphase is a preparatory phase where the cell is preparing itself for cell division. So all the logistics, whatever is required for the cell division, it is being accumulated during interphase.
Okay.
Okay, now in G1 phase, once we are talking about the G1 phase, so the G1 phase is the first phase of, you know what, this one of cell division, correct?
Yeah.
So here in the G1 phase, what is happening? G1 phase, there is accumulation of energy molecules, amino acids, or whatever is required, it is accumulated in G1 phase. It is accumulated. Whatever is required during the cell division means you need the amino acids, you need energy molecules like ATP and blah, blah, correct? Whatever you require, okay? So it is accumulated during G1 phase. So sometime whatever is required for the growth, it is accumulated during G1 phase.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, S phase is actually, S phase is for the synthesis phase. Okay. Synthesis phase. S phase, it is quite obvious. S phase is, in the S phase, the replication of DNA takes place. DNA material get doubled in S phase.
Okay.
This is the major thing that you just remember. And now, G2 phase, once we are saying, in books, some books, they are writing G2 phase is the final phase, obviously, isn't it, of the interphase. Then whatever is the cell organelles, whatever the cell organelles which are required by the cell, for example, one cell is dividing, it will be having only one organelle. For example, vacuole is one only, so it will be duplicated. So everything will be made, so all the organelles, they will be duplicated. If five ribosomes are there, so they will be making five more ribosomes. If there are three mitochondria, so three mitochondria will be replicated, they will be made. So everything, every cell organelle will be replicated.
Okay.
So once the cell divides into two or into four, so each cell gets equal amount of organelles, equal distribution. This is first thing.
Yeah.
Second thing, which is the most important thing, which is related, G2 phase is the checkpoint. This is the, actually, you know, for A-levels or for your class, you just remember, this is actually the checkpoint stage, checking point. What is the checkpoint like? Whatever, because during the S phase, the replication of DNA has taken place, correct?
Yeah.
So G2 phase is the final check whether the replication has taken place correctly or not. So if there is any mistake in the replication of DNA, any mistake, so this replication will be rectified. This is the really very important thing. Why? Because DNA replication, if there is any problem, so obviously it will be leading to a number of complications, isn't it? Like it can lead to number of syndromes, or not syndrome, number of problems like one gene, if it get disturbed, so obviously it will be causing a kind of mutation, and that mutation can be really harmful for the organism, correct? So mm-hmm. during G2 phase is actually the checkpoints, okay, where this replication of DNA which has taken place, it is revisited whether everything is done perfectly or no. If some mistakes are there during the replication of DNA, so those mistakes are being rectified. They is are properly checked.
Checkpoint name?
No, there is no checkpoint name. Only just, so this is G2 phase is actually the checkpoint phase. It checks out any mistake if it has taken place during the replication of DNA, so it will rectify that mistake.
Oh, so it duplicates organelles and checks for DNA replication.
Yes, normally the main focus is the DNA replication, because if the DNA has some mutation, some changes, so it will cause some damage to the new daughter cell or new organism which is developing, isn't it?
Yeah.
So this is the most vital stage of interphase.
Yeah.
Okay. So this interphase is over. One more thing is there. It is not as yet over. I will be talking a little bit more. Okay.
What's G-O?
G-naught. G-O means G-naught.
Where's
that? Once the cell is not going to divide any further, it takes a rest. For example, one cell is there, yes?
Yeah.
There is G1 and G-naught or G0, yes? Or G-O, whatever you call it.
Oh, so you either do G1 or G-O.
Yes. So G-O means a cell, for example, a permanent cell. There is an example. Permanent cells are the cells which are mature cells. They will never further divide. They cannot further divide. You know, there is one term that is known as Hayflick limit. Have you heard of this?
No.
Hayflick's limit. There was a scientist, Hayflick limit. This scientist actually, he contributed that one cell can divide maximum 40 times.
40?
Or 50 times. Actually, he gave the range between 40 to 60. So we take it as an average, 50 times. Okay? Mean, for example, this is one cell. This is one cell, okay? For example, this is a cell. So it can divide. Okay, first time it divide, yes? Then again, it will divide. Again, it will divide. Maximum, how many times it can divide? 50 times. After that, it cannot further divide. This is known as Hayflick limit.
Okay.
So once a cell reaches to the Hayflick limit, what does it mean? A cell is mature cell now.
Okay.
This is one thing. Secondly, you know, these cancer cells,
they just keep on dividing.
Yes. So it's mean they don't have any kind of Hayflick limit.
Okay.
They don't follow the Hayflick limit. You understand? Because of the mutation.
Yeah.
Got this point?
Yeah.
So G-naught phase is what phase? Where the cell cease to divide. It does not divide. So it can be in the permanent cells, like, for example, our nerve cells, they are permanent. They will be made only once in our lifetime. Nerve cells. If they are damaged, they will not be regenerated.
Yeah.
Similarly, our cardiac tissues, cardiac cells, they are made once. So they are the mature cells.
Okay.
Some of the cells, they can be regenerated, like muscle cells, normal muscle cells, yes? Smooth muscle, these muscles of our skin, yes? So yeah. These muscles, they can be replaced, they can be regenerated, but heart tissue cannot be. So you just remember, sometime what happened, a cell decide that I have to first take a rest. I will be dividing once it is required. For example, white blood cells. Isn't it? White blood cells, they start to divide only when there is a pathogen, and then they start to divide more. And you know this concept, like how this white blood cell, they interact first, they detect a pathogen, correct? And after that, what they do? They start to make copies of themselves, and maybe they will be making one particular antibody. Yes, to make that particular antibody, they will divide themselves in large number. So all of them, they will be making one antibody, correct? So, but before detecting the pathogen, they will stay the they will be having G naught phase. They are not dividing. There are G naught is also a resting phase, you can say.
Okay.
So they are waiting for, like for the seeds, they get dormant, yes? So they start to germinate only once there is favorable condition for them to grow.
Okay.
So same is the cells. Once they go into G naught, so G naught phase is actually dormant phase of a cell.
Okay.
It never divide. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay, now one more very interesting thing which is there that most of us being a student, we struggle. Now look, how the cell will come to know, now G1 phase is over and now I have to start S phase. And now S phase is over, now I have to start with G2 phase. Now the G2 phase is over, now we have to start with prophase. And prophase is over and now we have to start with meta and then ana and then the telophase, isn't it? How the cell comes to know about this?
Checkpoints?
Yeah, there are the checkpoints. Obviously, that is what you are asking me about the checkpoints. Yes, there are, in one way, these checkpoints, the checkpoints, I related this word with this, yes, replication of DNA, correct?
Yeah.
Similarly, the checkpoint, you can refer to the thing like one at the end of each phase. There are checkpoints. There are particular kind of checkpoints. Once those checkpoints will be detected, they will be like normally once there is a checkpoint, so this is achieved, this is achieved, this is achieved, this is achieved, correct?
Like CDK.
So at every checkpoint, there is a particular reaction, particular substance which will be made or which will be created. Correct?
Yeah.
No. There are some kind of proteins. These proteins are known as cytokines or cytokines. Okay, what are those proteins? They are known as cytokines.
Okay.
Cytokines or cytokines. Oh, no, not cytokines actually. Cyclins. What nonsense. Cyclins. Okay, there are the proteins. There are certain proteins like cycles. Okay, the word which is derived from the cycles. Okay, cyclins are the proteins. At each stage, there will be one particular protein. For example, at G1 phase, yes, one particular cyclin will be produced. This cyclin will be attached with one particular enzyme, which is known as CDK. Cyclin dependent kinase. Please make note of this, okay?
Yeah.
CDK, cyclin dependent kinase. So for example, there will be one particular cyclin 1. Cyclin 1 will be produced. So this cyclin 1 will combine with a particular CDK. So this is a checkpoint. When this complex will be made, so one particular variable is achieved, one particular target is achieved, this checkpoint is done. So some kind of changes will take place. Some kind of changes will take place in the structure of protein. I will explain you this thing, okay?
Okay.
Did you understand? Okay. Out of this, this is the most important part, okay? So cyclin, what are cyclins? Cyclins are proteins.
Yeah.
They are produced at each and every stage, correct? Every phase. One particular cyclin is actually responsible to unite with a particular CDK. cyclin dependent kinase. Kinase, wherever this word will come, it's mean
enzymes.
So they make a complex. So there is protein CDK complex is made. So this act as a checkpoint. So if one complex is made, it means G1 phase is achieved. You know, signaling, cell signaling molecules.
Yeah.
We have studied this thing in the cell structure, cell membrane structure. I think we did it together somewhere.
For Alzheimer's.
Yeah, yeah. And one more thing, for S phase also, there will be one particular CDK and protein, they will be combined together. So actually what happens in the CDK cyclin complex? There is a term that is known as phosphorylation. Phosphorylation of chromatin. Please make note of this thing, chromatin material. So once the phosphorylation of the chromatin material take place, it makes the chromatin network, the DNA, more condensed. Make note of this, please.
Yeah.
So CDK, so they result in the phosphorylation. Due to the phosphorylation, the chromatin material which is present inside the nucleus, it becomes, it further coiled, it get condensed. So during prophase, what happened? The chromosome, they become visible, isn't it? Yeah. Why the chromosome, they become visible? Because the chromosome, they become more condensed. They are coiled and further coiled and coiled, correct? So yeah. Each and every checkpoint, they coil, phosphorylation take place. So they are becoming condensed, then over-condensed like this, okay? This is first. So phosphorylation of chromatin result in the condensation of DNA, correct?
Yeah.
Similarly, CDK and cyclin complex result in the changes in the nuclear membrane structure also, the way it folds. It affects the folding of the nuclear membrane also. So what exactly has to happen with the nuclear membrane? Nuclear membrane ultimately has to vanish.
And it vanishes because of the CDK
CDK and cyclin and CDK complex, it actually, due to the phosphorylation of the membrane of nuclear membrane, it folds in a such a way, so there is a deterioration or change in the shape of the nuclear membrane, so it becomes more vulnerable to breakdown.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is the most important part we have covered now. Now we are moving. So once the interphase, which is the preparatory phase, which is over, then the cell enters into the active stages, which are pro, meta, ana, and telophase.
Okay.
Okay, what happens during prophase?
The chromatin condenses into a chromosome so it can divide properly.
Okay.
And
next,
spindle fibers start to grow.
Mm-hmm.
And the nuclear membrane disappears.
Okay.
And yeah.
Okay. So actually, you know, with the way I teach my kids, okay, so I'll be teaching you two things, that thing, okay?
Okay.
In prophase, two things, they appear, and two things, they disappear. Please, like this, you will remember, okay? Two things, they appear, they become visible, and two things, they disappear, okay? So what is appearing? So chromosomes, they become visible, yes?
Yeah, chromosomes.
Chromosomes become visible. Why do they become visible? You can explain. Because of coiling, CDK, blah, 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 isn't it?
Yeah.
Chromosome, they become visible. Why it is important for the chromosome to be coiled? Because now the genetic material has been doubled. So it is better to coil them together so they can fit into a small area. Yes?
Yeah.
So chromosome, they become visible. What is the second thing which become visible? Spindle fibers. Yes, spindle fibers, they originate or they become visible. Become visible or appear. Or they are made, whatever the word you are using. So two things, they become visible. Chromosome become visible due to the supercoiling. Okay, they get condensed. And second thing, spindle fiber, they start to originate. Either from where the spindle fiber originate in animal cells?
Centriole.
They look like a centriole. Very, very good. Very good. But in the case of plant cell, there is no centriole. Yes?
There's like another name.
You know, in a plant cell, there is no centriole. Yes? So yeah. You can say the spindle fiber, they originate from the two opposite poles.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, two things. Two things, they become invisible, they disappear. So first thing which disappear, that is nucleolus or nucleoli. Nucleolus disappear.
What's in
nucleolus
between nucleolus
yes.
and nucleus?
I'm sorry?
What's the difference between nucleus and nucleolus?
Okay, I will be. Look, for example, this is a cell, okay? And inside the cell, this is the nucleus, correct?
Yeah.
Nucleus is having a particular cell membrane, okay? Yeah. Now, nucleolus, once we are talking about nucleolus, it is a part, wait, I will be making here. It is the darker region of chromatin material.
Darker?
Without darker chromatin material. Inside the nucleus, yes? There is chromatin material, yes?
Yeah.
Genetic material is there. So one side is darker than the other. So it look like either it will be present in one form, it will be just look like an eye. But actually, it does not contain any membrane. Correct?
Yeah.
One more thing. Secondly, nucleolus or nucleoli is plural, okay? And nucleolus is a singular. So what is a nucleolus? The inside the chromatin material, which is dark in color, very dense and dark, that part is known as nucleolus, which is present inside the nucleus. This is the difference. It does not contain any membrane, correct? Nucleolus are responsible to produce, to make ribosomes. This is the region which are responsible to make ribosomes. So, you know, our teacher, he told us, nucleolus produce ribosomes, ribosomes produce proteins.
Yeah.
So nucleolus are the factories of ribosomes and ribosomes are the factories of proteins.
So
I think you will remember now.
Nucleus holds the nucleolus and DNA.
Yeah, obviously, actually nucleolus or nucleoli, they are the part of nucleus or genetic material, which is more dense part.
So next to the nucleolus, there's a DNA that's only inside the nucleus, not the nucleolus. Like in the white.
No, look here. This nucleolus and the whole structure, it is actually DNA inside.
Okay.
This DNA is darker and the other DNA is a little bit lighter in color. Okay. You know, there is a term, you know, I know, because this difficult thing, definitely you'll be knowing. What is the difference between ganglia and nerve?
I don't know.
Don't tell me. I was expecting this thing because it was a difficult question. Nervous system you have not done, yes?
No.
Okay. So cell bodies, you know this?
It's okay. We can come back to this. We can just finish the PMAT and then I'll do it.
No. No, this, you know what? The cell bodies, once we are talking about cell bodies, they are darker in color, okay? So once the cell bodies combine together, they make ganglia, okay? So nerve is actually lighter portion. So same is the case here. The case which is darker, that is nucleolus, and the lighter region is actually normal chromatin material.
Okay.
Now, next is here. Again, one more thing which disappear. What will be that disappearing thing? nuclear envelope. Actually, you know what? We are almost done with the topic.
We can do my
so
meiosis. Huh? We can also.
We will see now. We will see if we can continue with this meiosis. We will do. But actually, the thing is, this we have to focus first. Yes.
Yeah. Sure.
Chromosome. These are four things. Two things appear and two things they disappear. Correct.
Yeah.
In prophase. In telophase, telophase is total opposite of prophase. Whatever is appearing in prophase, that disappear, and whatever disappear in prophase, it appears in telophase. Opposite of pro.
Yeah.
You will never confuse this thing, correct? Now, during metaphase and anaphase, during metaphase, what happens?
The chromosome.
During the metaphase, two things happen, tell me.
The chromosomes line up in the middle, and the spindle fibers attach to the centromeres of the chromosomes.
Very, very good. What is the centromere?
The thing that holds together the
chromatid, two arms, correct?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard in your book the term which is kinetochore? Is this in your book, this term is there, kinetochore?
I think so.
Yeah. So now, again, this is the concept then, okay? So actually, you know the metaphase, what happened in the matter. The chromosome, they get lined up in the center of the nucleus or at equator plate, correct?
Yeah.
And then the spindle fiber, they attach to each chromosome at their centromeres, correct?
Yeah.
During anaphase, what happens?
The spindle fibers pull apart the opposite chromatid.
Yeah, the spindle fiber, they start to contract. And then the chromosome, they pull apart and they start to move to their respective poles. In this way, the this genetic material is equally divided, or chromosomes are equally divided between the two cells. Correct?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, the point which I'm going to tell you, what is kinetochore? Now, if we say this is the chromosome, yes? This is the chromosome, okay?
Yeah.
So, this area, this total area is mere means, M-E-R-E mean distance. So, whatever will be attaching here, okay? So, it is attaching in this distance, yes? So yeah. This is known as, obviously, this is centromere, correct?
Yeah.
Kinetochore is, now this is very interesting. A kinetochore is a place where one spindle fiber attach. So this spindle fiber is attaching at this point of centromere. So this point where the spindle fibers are attaching, this is known as kinetochore.
Okay.
Got it?
Yeah.
Class, we are done. So during telophase, what will happen? During the telophase, the nucleus will divide into two. So a nuclear division has completed. So one cell gets
half the
two nuclei inside, correct? After the nuclear division, correct?
Yeah.
A nuclear division is followed by the cytokinesis. Understood?
Cytokinesis is like the splitting of the
nucleus. Yes, splitting of this mother cell into two daughter cells. But cytokinesis means the division of cytoplasm.
Oh, yeah.
First, the nucleus is dividing. And second, the cytoplasm will be divided equally between the two daughter cells.
Oh, so that's a cleavage furrow thing?
Cleavage, yes. There will be a cleavage plate, correct?
Yeah.
So now the cleavage or splitting of the two cells, correct? In normal animal cell, what happened? This cleavage is controlled by centrioles. So what happens? Once this cleavage is happening, so for example, they centrioles, they make sure that the cell start to pinch inside, correct?
Yeah.
And divide into two equal halves, and every part of the cell, daughter cell, get one nucleus. It should not be like one cell is getting, one daughter cell is getting two nuclei and the other cell get zero nucleus.
So the centrioles create the spindle fibers and create the pinch of the cytoplasm membrane.
Very good. Yes, actually the word, because you are using good terms, so that is why I'm using centrioles are responsible for the furrowing. The word actually I'm using, furrowing. Furrowing of the cell. Division or pinching of the cell. They control this. So they make sure the cell, once it pinch down inward, yes, so each daughter cell get equal amount of cytoplasm, one nucleus, and equal amount of other cell organelles also.
So
equal distribution.
Is the thing pinching the cytoplasm membrane, like the inner membrane?
Yes.
Or the outer membrane?
Sorry.
What membrane is like splitting? Is it like the outer membrane or the inner membrane?
This is cell membrane.
Oh, okay.
This is the cell membrane. This is the cell membrane. Nucleus has further divided into two, correct?
Yeah.
No, this is outer cell membrane. Yes, this cell membrane. So there is no inner and outer. Hello, cell membrane is single membrane.
Sorry, I was thinking
of my nuclear membrane is double membrane.
Yeah. Wait, let me just show you a picture of what we had to do one class. And then,
yeah, show me.
I'm a little confused.
So now actually what I will be doing, so furrowing, you understood, just let me complete this thing, then we will be discussing your paper also, okay?
Yeah.
So you understood cytokinesis in plants, in animals, correct?
No.
You didn't understand the cytokinesis in animals?
Oh, this is animals, yeah. Sorry, I don't know it in plants.
Okay, now actually this is a furrowing, the term furrowing you understood, correct?
Yeah.
Okay, now in animal, in plant cells, the things are totally, completely different, okay? Let me see this thing, then I will go through with your question also. Maybe I will answer directly your question, okay? There is a possibility. Maybe the thing that you are looking for, I will answer by explaining this part.
Okay.
Okay, there is a possibility. Now look, if these are the two cells, okay? These are the two daughter cells. Nuclear division has taken place. This is a plant cell, yes? It cannot pinch down, yes? Why? Because there is a cell wall.
Oh, yeah.
So then here, there will be a particular thing is made, which is known as cell plate. Or division plate, whatever, there is one. What? Cell plate. Cell plate. A division plate. Okay? It start to develop here. You know what happened? The Golgi bodies are there, correct?
Yeah.
These are the vesicles, okay? These are the vesicles. These vesicles, this is one vesicle and this is the second vesicle, correct?
Yeah.
Once they will burst, for example, this vesicle, this is the vesicle. Once it will burst, what will happen? It will remove its nutrients like this, correct?
Yeah.
So these nutrients, they will be deposited around it. Then another vesicle will come and fuse with it. Then again, so again, there is a fusion of vesicles. So these fusion of vesicles, they start to develop a plate, equator plate or cell division plate, whatever the word we use. So it start to develop, like in the beginning it is smaller, then there are two, then it become bigger, then there is another merger of another vesicle, so it become larger and larger, and ultimately it actually divide these two. It takes as a cell wall. This is some, we call it cell plate.
So it divides it to nuclear envelope?
Yeah, no. The first thing is, what is the first thing? First, the nuclear division has taken place. Two nuclei, they are moved to the respective poles, correct?
Yeah, telophase.
Now, in like animal cell, there are the centrioles, and those centrioles, they actually help them to pinch in such a way that each daughter cell will get one nucleus, correct?
Yeah.
Furrowing, this you understood now, yes? Furrowing.
Yeah.
This part. Now, in plant cell, this is different. Why? First of all, there is no centriole. Secondly, plant cells, they cannot pinch inward. Why? Because cell wall is non-living.
Yeah.
So now what will happen? What is happening? One vesicle, for example, Golgi bodies are there, or Golgi vesicles are there, or lysosomes are there, okay? Yeah. One, this vesicle is there, okay? This is the vesicle. It will burst. It will make one layer like this, correct?
Yeah.
It is the bursted form, so it is one membrane, correct? Again, one more vesicle will come and it will fuse with this. This is just like bubbles. You know, have you ever seen kids, they once they blow the bubbles, yes, small with the, for the plane, yes? So once the two bubbles, they combine together, they make a large bubble.
Yeah.
This is the same concept. The vesicles, they keep on merging. They burst and they remove their material outside. So outside material, it makes the cellulose cell wall, and in between this, actually this part, it makes the cell membrane. It turns into the cell membrane.
Yeah.
You understand? So actually this cell membrane is developing in this way. So this will be the cell membrane. This will be the cell membrane of this cell, and this will be the cell membrane. Wait, I will be using another color. So this will be the cell membrane of this part. Okay, and this will be the cell membrane of this part. So in this way, this cell will be, in this way, they are joined together. So cell membrane, so they are, and in between them, what is there? Cellulose cell wall is there. Cellulose is there in between. So this is cell plate. Now I will be discussing the question paper that you have sent me, okay? I hope you understood this concept of cell plate.
Yeah.
Okay, my work is done. So I will be working with your work now. Okay.
Okay.
The mitosis is done with all the stages. And how does it happen? Okay. Before I go into further detail, can you just tell me of your questions? Can you tell me what are the advantages of mitosis?
Mitosis can be used for like production, repair, and
repair, very good. Okay, regeneration, you can see your body repair. Yes, this is a cell, this mitosis is the division of growth and body repair. One. Secondly, mitosis is the cell division of conserving genetic material generations after generation without variations, correct? So generation after generation, the genetic material remains the same. No variation, because they are the clones of the cells produced by the mitosis. They are clones of each other, correct?
Yeah.
Later on, they differentiate into different kind of, once we are talking about the clone, we are talking in terms of their genetic makeup, genes. Okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, these are the advantages. So, conserving the genetic material, okay, generations after generation without mutation. And secondly, and mitosis is faster. It is faster. For meiosis will take place only once one organism will reach its maturity or puberty. Got my point?
Yeah.
So this mitosis is fast growing division. It grows very fast.
Yeah.
So majority of the cells, they are organism, especially the lower organism, they follow the mitosis. Why? Because it is faster.
Yeah.
Bacteria divide by one process, which is known as what? Binary fission, correct?
Yeah.
Why can't we say binary fission mitosis, although it resembles to the mitosis?
People might get confused.
No. During a proper mitosis, there should be nuclear division and then there will be cytoplasmic division, cytokinesis. In bacteria, there is no nucleus.
Oh, yeah.
So this binary fission does not fulfill the definition of cell division like mitosis because nucleus is not there.
Yeah.
Okay. Then forms of the mitosis, there are grafting, budding, blah, blah. You can say a lot of examples are there, correct? Cuttings. Yeah. Correct? Now I'm done with this. Okay. What is the problem in the mitosis? What problems will happen?
Too many cells are dividing. DNA may not be replicated right. There might be mutations. The chromosomes might not line up equally in the center on the equal.
No. Mitosis, normally mitosis major problems are, first, it can be cancer. It can turn into tumor, correct? Because if the mitosis cannot be controlled, so tumor is actually uncontrolled cell division. Yes, mitosis.
Yeah.
Any problem, it can cause the tumor. Second problem with the mitosis is, if one disease is present, if one change has happened in genes, yes? So it will remain in that population generations after generation. Because if one disease, for example, one cell got infected with one particular pathogen, yes? Then all the cells, because they are genetically, they are the similar, so they will be genetically vulnerable.
Yeah.
So all of them, they will be vulnerable. So in this way, you can explain, you can read your book so you get the idea, okay? I'm done with this topic now, correct? Now what you can do, you can stop recording. So I will be discussing your question separately now. Okay? The topic mitosis, we are done.